Welcome back, friends. Today I have some small updates. In the last video I told right that there are some issue with the role, some functional issue with the role. For example, in the JSON request, this is a new JSON request. I have corrected something. In the project I have old one. Let me show you that. See here, the part of JSON request, I have given the role. First of all, this is the incorrect. The client should not send the role information. Backend system should take care of role information while registering new user. While registering new user, backend system should pick the default role. That default role should assign to the register user. Okay, that is the correct behavior. This need to be removed. The postman, I already removed that. Then the database, by default I created one role here. Whenever start the application, this record get inserted in the role table. This role is a default role, role_default. Whenever any user register, any type of user register in the application, this role apply to the user. This is the correct behavior. What I did is, previously, whenever register a new user, what happened? For that new user, this roles created as a new record. Again, if you register new user, again the same role created as a new record. Let's say I am registering three user. This roles information three time created with the same name. That is not correct. Okay. Role name should be unique. That's what I fixed now. I created one default role in the role table by default. Whenever start the application, this record get inserted in the role table automatically. That is the one I did. Next one is, I created one role service class. See, the billing service, there are some method. This is a default CRUD operation. Delete by ID, find by ID, find all, then save. This is a default CRUD operation. If you want, add any other SQL statement apart from default one. In that case, we need to create a new service class. That service class extend from billing service. So whatever CRUD operation available in the billing pay service, that available in the role service, apart from that, I am creating its own CRUD operation. I want to get role name by providing, I want to get the role record by providing the role name. Role, this method returning a role object, parameter is a role name. Okay, when providing any role name, if that role name exists in the database, this method returns the role. Okay, the registration service, I have done few things. In the registration class at line number 37, I am calling find by name method from role service class. The find by name accept one string parameter, which is a role name. That role name coming from here. This default role variable value is coming from property file. This is a default.role I defined in application normal file. Default.role contains role default value. Okay, this is a default role name. I mentioned default role name is a role_default. Okay, for this name, I have created one new record in a database already. See here, role_default. I want to get this record by providing name in the find my name method, which is coming from role service. Now this method return that record from the database and assign to role object. Here I initializing a list object. In that list I am passing a role, then that list I am setting to the user object. The user having a list object. The reason is one user can have multiple role. That is the reason I am creating a list of role in the user. At the time of registering, user can have only one default role. I am taking from the database then assigning to the user object. Now we are going to test a scenario. User already one record. That record is a vendor type, I think. It's a vendor type. User ID 2. User ID 2. Okay. Then user underscore role. User ID 2. Role ID 1. Role ID 1 is, what is the role ID? 1. It's a role default. Now I'll go and create another record, which is a customer type. The same role will assign to the customer without creating a new record. Customer and passing K7. Okay, I'm going to, it's started, our server is already started. Yeah, server is already started. I'll check the things. So the in the role table there is no any new record. We can see only the old record only. In the customer table, in the user table, we can see one more record get inserted. See, third user is 3, user ID is 3. It's a customer, right? So when you look at the customer table, user ID is 3, it's created. One record created. When you look at the user role, for user ID 3, role ID 1 is assigned. Role ID 1 is role underscore default. Okay, so whenever we register new user, for that user, by default, one role will get assigned. That role available in the database. Just we are reusing that record to assigning all the new users. After creating the user, there is an admin section. In that admin section, the end user can assign multiple roles to employee and vendors. Okay, that part we are going to see at the time of implementation. In the beginning of the video, I was saying that I have created one default row in the role table. That is a default role available in the role table. It's a role default. This record get populated whenever start the application. But this never populate each and every time you start the application. If the record is already exist, the duplicate record never populated. Through Flyway framework, I am achieving this. If any SQL statement already executed, Flyway framework never re-execute that particular SQL statement. Now we are going to see how to integrate Flyway framework part of this video. To manage SQL statement and manage the DML statement, I am using Flyway framework. We are going to talk about that now. See here, Flyway is a version control application to evolve your database schema easily and reliably. That is, this is my database schema now. Okay, the customer table, builder table, product table, there are many tables are there. Today I have one structure here, the address table, let's say address table. Today I have this the column in the address table. Tomorrow maybe I come up with any other column, or tomorrow maybe I'll go and remove any other column. That changes may happen any table in the billing database. So in that situation, I need to go and change, right? But we don't have that history. We cannot manage that history. If you use Flyway framework, we can manage that history information. Okay. So another purpose is we can execute SQL statement. We can migrate the data using Flyway framework. For example, I have some bunch of SQL statement. I want to migrate this SQL statement to a particular table. In such a situation, we can use Flyway framework. Using that feature only, I am inserting this record here. Okay. Let's see how to integrate Flyway framework in our billing project. The first step is go to pom.xml file. You need to add this artifact. This is for Flyway framework. Once you added artifact, you are almost done the configuration. Next step is create a folder called db.migration. Db is one folder. Under that, you need to create one more folder called migration folder. This folder should be under main folder from your billing system project. In this folder, I created a one SQL statement. Sorry, in this folder, I created a one SQL script. That script contains table definition of my billing system. The script contains table definition of my billing system. In the database, I removed all the tables. In the database, I removed all the tables. I want to re-execute all the tables through Flyway framework. So that I created a SQL script. That SQL script, I keep it in under migration folder. This is all my table. Okay. When you run this, when you start the server, make sure that your schema is empty. There is no table. Okay. When you run the SQL script using Flyway framework, in such a case, you need to keep your schema empty. Okay. So that I removed all the tables from the database. Now I want to re-execute all the tables. Now I'm going to start the server. The server is started. If you look at the database, refresh. See here now, all the tables were recreated. All the tables were recreated. Apart from these tables, you can see one more table called Flyway Schema History. Flyway Schema History. When you look at the data inside the table, it says version 1.1.1. Version 1.1.1. Then script file name is v1.1.1__initial_table.sql. This file I have given here, right? Here. So this particular file name maintained in this particular table, that table created by Flyway framework. Whenever restart the server again, your Flyway framework check this particular version of file already available or not. If already available, this particular file never executed again. Okay. The next one is I want to insert a table. Next one is I want to insert a record in role table. In the role table, I want to insert a default row. For that, I want to create one more file. That file is created here already. Copy here. In that file, I have added an insert statement. Insert into role. The default role I am giving here. Okay. When you restart this server again, let's see what's happening. Before that, I want to show you one thing here. Run the role table. The role table does not have any row. Now I want to rerun the server. Then our server started now. Now go to database, run the role table. Okay, see the role is inserted. Whatever insert statement I have given here, that particular value inserted here. This is default role default. See here, the value get inserted. The same value get inserted. When you look at Flyway schema history table, now one more entry get added. That is, but that row about this particular script. That row about this particular script. It says v1.1.2 role_default_insert_sql. Now when you rerun the server again, these two files never executed. The two files never executed because already executed, added in the Flyway schema history table. If you create any SQL script file, we need to follow some standards. that is prefix. Prefix underscore, prefix, then version, prefix version number, sorry, then double underscore, any name, dot SQL. This is a standard we have to follow. The prefix must be B. Version number, anything. Here I am maintaining 1.1.1. I start from 1.1.1. Then underscore underscore any name. I given my first version file, I given as a initial. Initial tables dot SQL. Then my second version I have given B is a mandatory. Then version name 1.1. Next version is 2. Underscore 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 is a mandatory. Then any name you can give. Default insert. So this is the standard you need to follow to maintain the SQL script version. Okay, if you want to do any changes again in some other table, let's say in the product table I want to add one more column. In that case, what you have to do is create a one more file by following the standard b1.1.3 underscore underscore product underscore add column dot SQL, something like that. You have to create a file. This is a mandatory, V is a mandatory, then follow your version, then underscore is a mandatory, then any name according to based on your SQL changes. Since I want to add a new column, in the product table, I am saying product underscore add underscore column, that is meaningful file name. Okay, you can add it under migration folder. Then add your SQL statement, restart the server. After restarting the server, whatever SQL script available inside the file, that SQL script reflected in your database. I hope you understand how to work with the Flyway framework to manage your SQL statement and SQL histories. In the next video, I'll come up with a good update. In the last video, I was saying that we'll see that exception handling, validation framework, and a logging framework, but I couldn't do that. The next video, definitely, I'm going to do those things. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video. Until then, bye bye from Suresh.